a column for a change.
Well, you've, I mean, 96 years old, you've seen a lot then, haven't you?
Yes, and it is interesting. The thing that amazes me is that when I wrote my first book, Kentucky and the Bourbons, 20 years ago, and by the way, Dr. Tom Clark wrote a very fine introduction to that book. We had to do all our research on foot in the archives and so on. My wife and I traveled to France. We traveled to Virginia, where the Meriwethers had come from. These days, you can sit at your computer, and it's amazing the information that you could bring back. I was able to, by typing in my father's name and his birthplace, I was able to come up with a report that there were 66 letters in the Oscar Browning collection of the of King's College, Cambridge, in England, that had been written by my father to Oscar Browning, who was a distinguished and eccentric scholar, in the process, I was able to learn what my father's life was like from the age of 11 till about the age of 15, where he was working on a farm, making comments about farming and his future and so on.
Let me ask you, this won't be your first book fair then, will it? You've been here on your two previous books?
This will be my third book fair.
Okay. What's been the experience for you at the book fair?
Pardon?
What's been the experience for you at the book fair? Do you look forward to attending?
I do. I certainly do. In fact, I just really am so much impressed with the Kentucky Book Fair, how well organized it is, and how many authors they bring in, including some who are have national distinction, and how well organized it is. How in the world an organization like the Book Fair organization can do all this largely with volunteers?
Right.
Sitting there is a point of contact is Connie Crow, who's always responsive to my inquiries, and who somehow or other keeps her finger on everything that's going on, but she certainly relies on a core of volunteers who do a monumental job in making this very successful fair an annual success.
Well, if you don't mind me saying, I think, you know, a book such as yours is very important. I mean, it's because a lot of people don't realize how horrific war can be, especially
yes.
World wars. And I think what you've done is really... should be an eye opener for a lot of people.
There's an increasing interest in the world wars, and I found that out in the process of writing my columns. A lot is not known about World War I because of it took place 90 years ago. And World War II is fast receding into people's memories as well, and I think that's one of the reasons there's an increasing interest, and I think an increasing interest in reading about those days.
Well, listen, Susie and Ronald, I thank you both for being here today. I'm looking forward to the book fair, and I'm sure a lot of people will show up and buy your book.
Yes. Thank you for having us.
Well, thank you, Mike, for all your efforts at arranging this and for all you do for the fair.
Well, thank you, sir. Well, as we mentioned, the book fair will be November 9th and 10th. And I want to mention a couple of the national authors, Stephen Pastis, cartoonist, Mary McDonald, who played Erin Walton on The Walton. She has a book out, and she's going to be in attendance. Dandy McCall, a New York Times bestseller, Judy Rosenberg, who's known as a baker. I don't have a whole lot of information about her. Then we have some distinguished Kentucky authors in addition to these fine folks, Wendell Berry, Bobby Ann Mason, Silas House, Gurney Norman, Ann Gabhart. And on Children's Day, we'll have Debbie Daddy and Marcia Thornton Jones, Martha Bennett Stiles, Steve Flaherty, Leanne Florence, Mark Wayne Adams, Mike Norris, and Minnie Atkins. Really about 30 authors will be there on Children's Day. So we want to thank you for joining us today, and we'll have two more programs in the coming weeks. But again, don't forget to mark your calendars November 9th, November 10th, Frankfort Convention Center. Thank you.